Time to find out what's cooking on this Friday, and it's one of our favorites back with us, Chef Jules Shepard from Nearly Normal Cooking. Good to see you.
Hi, good to see you again. Thanks.
And Nearly Normal because she does everything gluten-free, okay. And you're out with your second book.
Yes, just came out in December.
You are busy.
The first year, celiac disease and living gluten-free.
Very good. And so what are you going to do gluten-free for us today?
Well, I'm going to show you how to make this wonderful brownie recipe, and then you guys get to taste the finished product.
Okay, and we have to.
Yeah.
If I have
twist
to eat chocolate
your arm
brownies,
on the chocolate.
I will.
Yeah. And then I'm also going to finish frosting this beer cake that I made with gluten-free beer, and it's all dairy-free as well as gluten-free. So I'll talk about that as well.
Gluten-free beer.
Yes. It's
brand
new.
That's a new thing, huh?
It is, yep.
So there's beer in that chocolate cake,
there's
going to be frosting on it?
Yes.
Do you need someone to taste that too?
I think so, yes. That would be very helpful if you would mind helping me out on that at the end.
Somebody's
doing your part.
Somebody's got to do it.
That's right.
I think it's going to be a pretty good What's Cooking Friday. What do you guys think?
See, good and good for you.
Bring it on.
Beer, chocolate, and gluten-free.
It better taste good.
It will.
Taste good.
Okay.
Because Jules has been on a couple of times. It is delicious.
Yeah, she never disappoints.
All right.
Hopefully you're not disappointed
on the success of the adoptions.
Great.
Let's head on over to Studio B. See what Holly's got cooking this morning.
Well, Austin, you know, we were dealing with design dilemmas a little earlier. Now we're going to deal with dietary dilemmas. And the chef with the answer is Jules Shepard from Nearly Normal Cooking.
Yeah.
And we're talking gluten-free. And you and I were talking a little bit because a lot of these, you know, a lot of people that eat gluten-free need to be dairy-free because they're lactose intolerant.
Yep.
You know, there's allergies involved there. So this is an answer to a lot of that.
Yeah, it actually solves a lot of problems. Eating gluten-free is great for people who have celiac disease, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a whole bunch of people out there who have gluten intolerance. They just have a hard time digesting wheat or other glutens. And it also, a lot of people are finding that with their autistic children, that they're responding really well to a gluten-free diet. It reduces some of the behavior problems and things like that. So there's lots of folks trying a gluten-free diet, but as you alluded to, there are a lot of people out there who are eating other, you know, free diets.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the whole free-from market is really
right,
big. So
exactly.
A lot of my clients, and when I teach cooking classes and around the country, I meet with people all the time who are dairy-free.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of egg-free people. Other people have, obviously, nut allergies and things like that. So I change recipes around for people to help them out. And what we're going to do today is something that's really sinful and not dairy-free, which
mm-hmm.
is the brownies, first of all. But then I'm going to show you a dairy-free recipe as well.
All right, well, let's keep going.
This is what I'm doing here. First of all, let me just show you a little tip since we're doing the design on a dime thing,
mm-hmm.
too. A lot of people don't have a double boiler. So what I did is I just brought this in to show people how you do it. I'm slowly melting these chocolates for the brownie recipe in my handmade little double boiler here. I just had two pans at home, and I just fashioned my own double boiler. You
good
don't have to go
you.
Out and buy.
Right. You
I mean,
buy,
no,
like,
no, no, no.
A specific double boiler.
No,
it does the same thing.
Absolutely. So what we're going to do here today, and you can stir if you want to.
Sure.
Just with
I'm
that.
Stirring
yeah.
away.
Stir, stir, stir. And I'm going to stir the sugar in here like this, real
mm-hmm.
slowly. Just stir. And I actually have a bigger spoon, too, so. Stir that all up
this
right now.
This plastic knife is just
it's
working
just not
wonders.
Cutting it. Yeah. Well, so, and then we're going to do the eggs.
Mm-hmm.
And
this is just regular sugar, right? Regular white sugar.
That's regular white sugar, exactly. And we are going to add the eggs to that. Mix those up a little bit here. Just whisk them together real lightly. You're doing a great job.
Well, you know.
You're putting that plastic knife to work there.
I've done a brownie or two in my
yeah,
life.
Yeah, you look
usually
like a brownie
out of a box,
expert.
But no.
Well, and that's for people who eat gluten-free, that's the thing, is that if you can buy a few of these mixes, and I actually, my product line has some mixes in it, but it's actually a lot cheaper if you just have a flour and you make it yourself at home. And it's so easy. I mean, look, this is all you have to do is just
yeah.
stir this together. This is
and we have just under a minute, so
coffee.
I'm going to make sure we get it all in.
I'm adding coffee.
Oh,
yes,
really?
Coffee and chocolate are wonderful
yeah,
together.
Yeah, they are.
Stir that in there. There's the vanilla. And I added these wonderful cherries to mine. And here, we'll just toss it right in. I think we're ready to go.
Just like enough of you.
Yeah. No, 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 no.
Hand the kitchen
back no,
over.
No, 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 no. You did a fantastic job. Look at that. It's so pretty. It smells so wonderful.
It does smell
good. People at home could smell this. It's wonderful. Anyway, we'll just stir this in here like this. And another little handy trick, just everybody's looking to save time. Instead of having a big old brownie pan to have to deal with afterwards, I line them with foil, like this. And I just pour the brownie mixture in there.
Exactly.
And then when you're done, you just lift it out and you don't have to worry
about it. No washing needed.
Exactly.
I actually knew that tip myself. Exactly. I do that.
Do you?
Try to limit washing as much as possible.
I knew that. So there's the cherries all stirred in there like that. And then I'll just pour that in here and out with them.
Through the magic of television.
Exactly.
Is that.
Ta-da.
Unfortunately, we're out of time. Mm-hmm. So when we come back, we'll comment on the other.
Sure.
But don't forget, our recipes are online at myfoxdc.com. Mm-hmm. We'll taste it up and we have another important recipe you're going to want to see when we come back on
Great.
The other side. So stay with us.
Thanks.
Welcome back. We are hanging out with Jules Shepard from Nearly Normal Cooking, and she's got one other great recipe you want to share with us.
And this is online. This is a beer cake, and most people think with gluten-free you can't have beer, but there's these great beers out now. These are true Belgian beers.
Which is,
they
I was going to say, it's good beer.
This one's actually like a Guinness, and I use that in this cake. And this is also dairy-free, so I used a soy mixture on the top, and it's really, really tasty. But you swirl it around like that, and it looks like the head of a beer. And, you know, isn't that neat? Isn't that fun?
Oh,
so anyway,
fun.
You guys can taste this and the brownies. We got lots of good stuff for you today, and I did bring
Okay, who's tasting what?
I'll taste the beer cake.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll taste the beer cake.
You have some dibs on that beer cake.
I will taste a brownie.
Okay, taste a brownie. Here we go.
Yeah, you got...
Split this. And her second book just came out in December, by the way, so don't forget about that.
Okay. There you are. You guys want to split
that? Let's split it, Holly.
Okay. Hey, Allison, you want a brownie or beer cake?
I'll try the brownie.
You want to play?
Frank, come back over here. Frank, designer of time. I know you're out of brownies. Come on in.
What a full house.
Yeah.
Great show. Thanks for watching.
Great Friday, better weekend.
It's the Friday.